Paris, from the Eiffel Tower to the Arc de Triomphe to Notre Dame, it seems this city is jam-packed with history. But how far does this history go back, and is anything left of Paris's origins? Today, we're going to go back in time nearly 2,000 years and discover a few key places that have amazingly survived to this day in modern-day Paris. The first record of Paris in history was by the Romans at the Battle of Lutèce in 52 BCE. A Gaulish tribe called the Parisii first settled the area, likely in what's now the Rive Gauche, or left bank of the Seine River. After the Roman conquest, a small city called Lutetia developed from a population of conquered Gauls and Romans. The town eventually had around 8,000 inhabitants, and like any proper Roman city, featured its own forum, amphitheater, and public baths. So after nearly two millennia of continued human presence in Paris, what's left of Roman-era Lutetia? First, we start at the Rue Saint Jacques, at the top of the generously named Montagne Sainte Geneviève. This road was the main thoroughfare of Roman-era Lutetia. Today, it remains a significant street in Paris's 5th arrondissement. To the right, you would have seen the Roman Forum, which was the head of government for Lutetia, but it no longer exists, and it doesn't correspond to modern-day street locations. While the Forum didn't survive into the modern era, two other great amenities from the same time period did. The Thermes de Cluny, or Cluny Roman baths, are still partially intact to this day. The baths, built between the 1st and 2nd centuries CE, originally occupied 6,000 square meters of space. It's now part of the Musée de Cluny, which is currently under renovation until 2022. You'll have to wait to visit the inside of the Frigidarium, or cold baths, and admire the still intact 14-meter high arch ceilings. Still, from outside the museum gates, you can admire the original Roman brickwork and see the outside of the Frigidarium, which still retains its roof. The caldarium and tepidarium, or hot and tepid rooms, are open to the elements, so are still visible from outside. Next, we head to the Arène de Lutèce, or Arena of Lutetia. This was the amphitheater of Roman-era Lutetia. It can hold up to 17,000 spectators in its heyday. It held plays, gladiator fights, and even a mock naval battle with miniature ships. You can see the niches where wild animals like lions were held before fights. The Arène de Lutèce was forgotten over time, and eventually new buildings were built on top of it. In the late 1800s, it was rediscovered, and it was finally restored in the 1920s. Today, the Arène de Lutèce is a public park. You're free to walk inside the arena and imagine the life of a gladiator, or sit on the stone steps and admire the view as a spectator. The vineyard built atop the steps is not original to my knowledge. The park is well worth a detour during your next trip to Paris. You'll notice that the name Lutetia didn't stick. The official name in the Roman era was Lutetia Parisorium. The second part of the name refers to its original inhabitants, meaning the Parisii tribe. Over time, this evolved into the Paris that we know today. The fact that most of the Roman settlement was in what's now the 5th arrondissement of Paris is why we now refer to the neighborhood as the Quartier Latin, or Latin Quarter. Since this channel is all about cross-cultural influences, what effect did Roman colonization have on the Parisii and other Gaulish tribes? Over time, Gaul became France, a country unmistakably influenced by the Romans. Linguistically, the modern French language has little left of its Celtic roots. French is now counted as one of the Romance languages, which derive from Latin. France's legal system derives from the Roman empires, although it has evolved enormously since then. The Roman Catholic Church, in some ways a successor to the Western Roman Empire, had a long-standing influence on France's society and culture. Since the Renaissance, a newfound ancient Roman influence has been visible in French art, architecture, and philosophy. Highlighting these deep roots, the cities of Paris and Rome have been twin cities since 1956. What's unusual, however, is that no other city enjoys this distinction. The two cliquish cities have determined that only Paris is worthy of Rome, and only Rome worthy of Paris. But just like the city itself, France's culture has added on new layers to these Roman foundations, so the origins aren't always apparent. But now you know, a little bit of ancient Lutetia is still left in Paris. If you want to see Roman artifacts from Lutetia, the recently reopened Musée Carnavalet has artifacts from prehistory up to the 20th century. I hope you enjoyed this trip back in time. Subscribe to our channel for more videos on cross-cultural interactions and their effects on culture, history, and geopolitics. See you next time.